Hello everyone, greetings from National Skills Network, which is popularly known as NSN. And today we are continuing with some of our guest talks, skill talks. And today we are going to feature a talk with Mr. Sanjeev Sharma, who is President, Empower Pragati. And he is going to tell us more about PMKVY 3.0 and connect it with PMKK and many other related aspects. So welcome to this talk, Mr. Sanjeev Sharma. I'm so glad to meet you today and ask you a few questions for the benefit of our audience. So can we get started by asking you the very basic question, which is concerning PMKVY 3.0. What is different in PMKVY 3.0 from the other schemes? Let's get started.
Thank you so very much. Thanks indeed. The difference between PMKVY 3 and PMKVY 1 and 2 is, I would say, very simple. PMKVY 1 used to be certificate-driven scheme, where government used to say that, okay, let us give vocational education to students and give them a certificate which is recognized by bigger companies, private companies and all, who recognize that yes, this scheme, this education, vocational education is certified and it has a meaning. It is not like that we are just imparting some knowledge to students and all that. So that was mainly, it was launched on 15th of July 2015 and the whole objective was to do a certificate. Giving a certificate. So it was more of a certification driven scheme, PMKVY 1. And under that, about 20 lakh students were trained. Now coming to PMKVY 2. PMKVY 2 has been more of a, that this scheme has been more of a, like government decided that students should be given vocational education, the training, which should have meaning or related to projects like Make in India, Digital India, Swachh Bharat, and so on and so forth. So ministry decided that, okay, let us start bigger training centers and all that. Like Empower Pragati, we are today in 6 states and we have 28 PMKK centers and all that. So the whole objective, and the 33 SSCs working into this. So here it was more of a employment centric. Like the first one was more of a certificate centric. The second one was more of a employment centric, where government said that let us give the ensure that whatever we are teaching or training to students, they get a job. And if they can get a job, where like how to make this scheme of our minister Make in India successful. Give a training in those specific job roles where students can join Make in India kind of organizations, or like get involved in Swachh Bharat, or get involved similar kind of schemes launched by our Honorable Prime Minister. So this was PMKVY 2. Now come the PMKVY 3, where government said that, okay, so far it was like small centers. Today centers are there, tomorrow centers are not there. So they said that they launch a scheme PMKK, where government said that center should be minimum 8,000 square feet. It was a bigger center. These centers should be for a longer period. It should be for at least 3 years, 5 years, or 10 years kind of a thing. And government also said that let us involve district skill councils and state skill mission councils also in this, and also ensure that the students, suppose like what happened in pandemic, lot of students, they were never interested in going to other districts or especially other states. Even parents were not very happy to send them to other states and all that. So government said that, okay, we start a bigger center and we do a STT, which is a short-term training, and RPL, recognition of prior learning, and also give a training where districts and states are fully involved. They come up with the job roles where students can get jobs in the same districts or same state. So they don't have to think that, okay, I can't go to the other state and so on and so forth. Basically, PMKBY3 is, this is how it is different from PMKBY1, which is certificate driven, 2 was employment driven, and 3 on a very broad base.
So this is. Yeah, so as I understand the evolution of PMKVY, PMKVY3 is more focusing at the grassroots level and also trying to see how to match the requirements in the local industry, like you said, and trying to stop migration or forced migration and create jobs at the level, right?
Absolutely. And as I said, PMKVY 1 mein 20 lakh were trained, 2 mein 1 crore were trained, and in 3 mein 8 lakh, out of which main were RPL, recognition of prior learning, and lesser were short-term training.
Okay.
And they say about 1,000 crore rupees government is spent in PMKVY 3.
Yeah. So another observation that I have, which I would like to share, is now we say that we are moving towards more of demand-driven training through PMKVY rather than target-driven, which used to be the case earlier. Can you tell us a bit more about this as well, how it is happening currently?
Correct. So here, what it has always been that 75% amount was spent by central government and 25% amount was spent by state governments. Now, what government said, they said that it should be more of a district-driven skill council should get involved and state skill missions should get involved. And they are the one who should come up with kind of job roles which are available in particular districts or in particular states. So in decentralization, this is what they said. They said that, okay, demands will be created for those particular job roles, which was not earlier. Earlier, it used to be like that, fine, these are the job roles available, irrespective of whether those job roles related jobs are available in particular districts or in particular states is there or not. So now this was the difference between them.
And how does this impact the training partners who are already established and who want to continue with skilling? And as we understand, COVID has really affected a lot of training partners in the last 9 months or so. So how does it impact the training partners now? And how does it impact people? Or how does it help people who want to get into this activity of skilling people and maybe avail schemes like PMKVY3?
You see, unfortunately, pandemic has been there and we all pray that we should never ever see it again in our lifetime. But then pandemic has taught a lot of things. And it obviously used to be very, very painful seeing laborers walking thousands of miles barefoot going from one place to their home districts and hometowns and so on and so forth. And also, these are the negative things which we saw during pandemic. We also saw a lot of positives during the pandemic. And in some way, it turned out to be blessings in disguise also, if I can say so. Because you see, earlier, we never thought that we can connect to 500 people at a time. And during pandemic, we were so happy that our MD has been regularly during lockdown has been addressing our trainers on a very regular basis, pan India. And we were addressing at a time 500 people. That's one. We have been continuing the online training of students in all the projects, whether it is PMKVY or it is DDGKY or NSKF. In all the projects, we have been conducting training to students. So you see, that was a very, very big lesson we learned during pandemic, that it is not difficult to address people sitting in one corner, you are sitting on other corner, one is on the left, the other is on the right, and you are addressing 500 people, somebody is in one corner, other is different corner. So from all four corners, we could address people, and not only our employees or trainers, but students also. lot of summer camps were organized. So all these kind of things were done. Also, you see, during this, our Prime Minister came up with Atmanirbhar Bharat. So where training partners like us, we launched Udyamita project, where we taught students to become entrepreneurs. We started training them how to become entrepreneurs, which helped them to start their own business. And not only that, also employ a lot of their friends, their colleagues, their peers, and so on and so forth. So this has been the difference. The use of technology came, which was not thought of earlier. The entrepreneurship came for the students. Training partners got a lot of benefits during this. So these were the also, it was like vocal for locals. We again came up that fine, okay, let us once again, I would repeat that in this particular district, these are the industries available. So let us ensure that we give a vocational education to students who can be absorbed in the local factories or local job opportunities, they can get it. So all those benefits were there.
Yeah. So I think this is something nice to hear, the positive side that you just told us. And connected with it, I would like to ask you a question. So is this also going to focus on, let's say, some new kind of skills that are to be offered post-COVID? Is there a change in that? Can you mention few skills that are going to be very prominent?
Yes, certainly new job roles are, SSCs are working towards new job roles. We are also, in fact, SSCs have been asked also that they should start working towards checking with, let us say, existing business businesses, various businesses, that what actually is the requirement of individual business houses. Let us say someone says that, listen, we are into this industry and we would prefer these kind of vocational education or training given to these students whom we can absorb in our factories. So it is that there is going to be a whole lot of changes in this. Earlier, but now there are 33 SSCs. Earlier it used to be much lesser. So it is going to be expanded further into that. So those changes are inevitable.
Yeah. And also now, if we look at it from the student side or the young people's side, do you think there will be a considerable change for the learners or people who undergo PMKVY courses, let's say from the one which is in 3.0 scheme?
What we have started with, when we do mobilize the students, candidates, we do their counseling. We not only them counseling, we also counsel their parents. We prepare them for a specific type of job roles based on their aspirations, their interests. When we do counseling, we check that. Fine, maybe some students are more interested in, let us say, retail, some students are interested in hospitality sector, some are more interested in IT. So when we counsel students, we also check that what is their interest level. It should not happen that, okay, fine, we want to give them a training in, let us say, retail sector, whereas their main interest is in IT sector. So we try to gather a lot of information from them, from their parents also, and then we decide that, fine, this particular student should go into IT, should go into retail. We are also doing Kiran sessions in Empower Pragati, where we do a lot of things. We, in fact, give lectures and trainings, create awareness about unemployment, importance of skills, gender equality, financial inclusions, all these kind of things under Kiran project we do, which is run by Empower Pragati. So here again, when we go to the villages and all that, we also involve village mukhiyas and all that in this.
And you just mentioned about mobilizing. With that, I just wanted to ask you, perhaps this would be my last question. In the Sankalp scheme and the PMKVY, the connection which is happening now, we also read that it is not the training partner who has to take care of mobilization and related activities. So is there a change to this effect? And please tell us a little more about Sankalp and PMKVY together.
Sankalp is a World Bank funded program, and in this it is designed to strengthen short-term training, and duration of these courses are 3 to 6 months. Now under PMKVY3, we offer a lot of short-term trainings also to students, which is in sync of Sankalp. Sankalp, it is more of a decentralization, is the pivot of Sankalp program of Ministry of Skill Development. So the whole goal is to strengthen skilling development governance. In this district skill committee, they are mandated to do planning and skill training to reach maximum people horizontally and vertically. Here in Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Kendra, what are like presence in every districts and all is there. So in this program, what is the connection between Sankalp? As I said, the decentralization. PMKKs are out of the center. We make it, as I said, we have to make it a bigger centers which should last longer. And in this, we should do all these short-term trainings also of 3 months and 6 months, provide immense opportunities to SC, ST students, person with disabilities, student, women, so these kind of things. So this is all the whole objective of this.
Okay. So besides these points, is there something else you would like to share with us before we close this conversation?
I have one thing which I would like to tell all the people who are involved in the training. I always say that we are not on this earth by chance, but we are here for a reason. And in skilling, and the whole objective is that we grow like a mountain, not to shrink like a grain of sand. So similarly, in skilling business, we are not by chance. We are for a reason, and the reason is to transform lives. The whole objective is to transform lives. Hamara objective in skilling business should not be to make money. Ye skilling business un logo ke liye nahi hai jo business karke paisa banana chahte hain. Ye skilling ka business un logo ke liye hai jo imandari ke saath life transform karna chahte hain. Aap dekhiye, governments, they are putting lot of efforts. They are working with us day in, day night. They try their best कि हम लोग जो है इंडिया में जितनी भी यंग पॉपुलेशन है उनको कहीं ना कहीं अब्सॉर्ब करें, अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट को कम करें. तो इसको अगर स्किलिंग को लोग एज अ मनी मेकिंग बिजनेस लेंगे तो देन इट इज नॉट गुड. सो आई वुड रिपीट दैट वी आर नॉट ऑन दिस अर्थ बाई चांस बट फॉर अ रीजन. And the reason is to grow like a mountain, not to shrink like a grain of sand. Similarly, we are not into a skilling business by chance, but we are for a purpose, and the purpose should be and is to transform lives.
Wow, that's really amazing. I think these words are very inspirational about transforming lives and finding a purpose. So on this note, I would like to thank you, Mr. Sanjeev Sharma. Thanks for talking to me today, and I would like to be in touch with you. Thank you so much.